بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. Our case today is surgical case. This baby is full term, has not fed well since birth. Since birth is not fed well and noted to have bilious vomiting. Also abdominal distension. After 48 hours of age, this abdominal distension, it was mild, it became worse actually after 48 hours. So this, the clue from these questions, the bilious vomiting. Bilious vomiting indicate intestinal obstruction until proven otherwise. Also, the cardinal sign for intestinal obstruction is 4. First of all, vomiting or bilious vomiting, abdominal distension, constipation. The patient is not pass philetus or the bowel is not open. This is the cardinal sign indicate this patient has intestinal obstruction. But our case here is bilious vomiting. If you see the scenario here, this is bilious vomiting. Term baby, not fed well, and there is bilious vomiting. Bilious vomiting indicate intestinal obstruction until proved otherwise. Abdominal distension also, this distension of the abdomen or indicate lower intestinal obstruction. It will be in the distension of the abdomen, it's late indicate or give you clue, this is lower intestinal obstruction. Can be upper, but also, but both in your mind, it will be lower. So this is the clue in this scenario. Bilious vomiting indicate this is surgical case, indicate intestinal obstruction. Abdominal distension, but more commonly with lower intestinal obstruction. It can be happen with the upper, but it's commonly with the lower. So we can see this x-ray. This x-ray, we need to comment about what does the x-ray show, and also what do you think has happened for these patients, and the third, what will you do next and how to treat this patient. So this is abdominal x-ray. First of all, I have to comment about, you see up here, if you have to comment about this free air. You see, there is free air under the diaphragm. Free air under the diaphragm. This free air in the peritoneum. If you goes here in the left side also, there is free air here also, hypertranslucent area. This is free air also here. And the diaphragm was thick. Diaphragm thick. Thick indicate the perforation. Any thickness indicate there is perforation or impending perforation. If the bowel wall thick, indicate there is some material affected the wall and indicate or impending perforation. Impending perforation. If this perforation is cannot appreciated or if you are doubted, you can do lateral x-ray or cross table x-ray or right side up to look for the perforation or the free gas in the peritoneum. Also here, if you see here also, is this air. If you can see here some air also here, air, but more prominent up here in the air under the diaphragm. You can free air under the diaphragm or the free air in the peritoneum. So this is the first cardinal sign. This is free air under the diaphragm and the diaphragm was thick. And if you go down here, if you see here, if you go down here also the in the rectum, no gas in the rectum. If you go here also, no gas in the rectum. No gas in the rectum indicate intestinal obstruction until proved otherwise. Until proved absent gas in the rectum, also it will give you clue there is intestinal obstruction or lower intestinal obstruction. So what else you can help us here? Here we said here also there is you see here there is no gas in the rectum. You see here. What else? Comment about the bowel. You see the bowel loop dilated. Bowel loop dilated. And thick bowel wall. يبقى bowel loop dilated and the wall is thick. Thick wall. Thick wall indicate impending perforation. Impending perforation. So this x-ray, there is free air under the diaphragm and thick diaphragm and no air in the rectum. And also if you look for the bowel loop, it's dilated and thick. This indicate what? Indicate intestinal perforation or pneumoperitoneum. This is what in the x-ray and give you clue. This is intestinal obstruction, most probably lower intestinal obstruction, most probably colonic obstruction as our case here. So what are going to do for these patients? This is a free gas in the peritoneal cavity, and there is dilated bowel loop, several which appear have been very irregular and thick wall. Also, the right diaphragm appear to be thick and no gas in the rectum. Diagnosis, this is intestinal perforation based on the free air under the diaphragm, and probably being present sometime to result in degree of bowel loop thickness has been apparent. If there is bowel loop or bowel wall thickness, it means this, for long time this perforation, it was long time for these perforations. Presence of irritant material also probably responsible for thickening of the diaphragm. Thickening the diaphragm of thick, this means there is irritant material affecting the diaphragm. It's not clear why the bowel has been perforated, but absent rectal gas will be suggestive of obstruction. This baby case of colonic atresia. This baby has colonic atresia. Based on what colonic atresia? Based on the clinical background, because the baby have bilious vomiting, not feeding well, abdominal distension, and worse after 48 hours, based on the clinical background. Based on the radiological finding, there is free air under the diaphragm and thick diaphragm, and also the bowel loop is dilated and thick and no gas in the rectum. This will give you clue about this is intestinal obstruction, most probably it's lower, and for this case, actually diagnosed as colonic atresia. If any thickness of the diaphragm, thickness of the bowel loop indicate this is long time intestinal perforation, since long time, yani it's not discovered immediately, it's actually it takes time. So what is the treatment? The treatment of intestinal perforation, there is free gas. You have to drain this free gas. This free gas will need to drain or to insert drain unless laparotomy is performed immediately. So we mentioned this before, shall we do drain or laparotomy? If drain, actually if the patient less than 1 kilo or if unstable, especially for premature babies, it will be the drain is better for unstable patient. Stable patient can go for laparotomy. But in your mind, any laparotomy of the patient went for laparotomy, the mortality rate it will increase by 50%. And now the people is talking about to drain to be the definitive management rather than to do laparotomy. So this case, you have to drain it or to send for laparotomy immediately if indicated. And surgical review is essential, and the baby should be stabilized as dictated by clinical condition of this baby. At the end, I would like to pray to my colleague. It's going for exam, Arab board, Saudi board, Jordanian board, and Egyptian board, and my colleagues in the neonatal fellowship. Ask Allah رب العرش العظيم أن يجعل زملائنا جميعا يا رب وأن ينفع بهم يا رب إن شاء الله. شكرا. سلام عليكم.